arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, TattleTales. And here's the star of TattleTales, Bert Convy.
Everybody, welcome to TattleTales. Thank you for tuning us in. It's nice to have you with us today. I hope you're having a lovely summer, have had a lovely summer, wherever you are. Here, it's terrific. These people are all dressed so bright, colorly. Oh, you look terrific. Y'all going to win some money today? Okay. You come and see us when you come to California, and you can win some money, too. And here are the people that are going to win the money for our studio audience today. Winning money for the blue section. There he is, Mr. Dickie Dawson and his gal, Jody Donovan.
We had that summer romance. I asked you not to call me Dickie.
I just thought of that as I said it. I was going to turn around and say, do you mind if I call you Dickie? You don't like that.
I hate
what
that.
What do you like, Richard?
Florence. Richard.
Okay, Richard. Yeah. Richard it is. How are you, Richard?
Top of the world. You look great.
Thank you, sir.
I enjoyed you very much in Vegas.
Oh, thank you.
Did a good job.
Very sweet of you to say that.
He's playing in your town. Go and see him. He's excellent.
Well, isn't that nice? That's about all the time we have for today, folks. How are you, Jody? Yeah, it's nice to have you back with us. You look lovely. Winning money today for the banana section. First time with us, as a matter of fact. Rookies, Mr. Bo Hopkins and his gal, Sondra. It's nice to see you again, Bo. I haven't seen you since the tennis court.
Yeah.
Past you once in a while. You still practicing?
Well, yeah, practicing. Not playing too well. Practicing.
Well, you've been shooting a lot of movies, too. You've been down... you were up in San Francisco with Jimmy Kahn doing Killer Elite, right?
Yeah, we was up there about 10 weeks.
Right. Sondra, how are you?
Petrified.
Really? Oh, good. The banana section loves to get them that way. No, the banana... You're lucky. See, your first time on the show, but you got the banana section. They're so sweet. They're the loveliest people in the world. See?
Don't throw things at me.
No. If they do, it's a banana. It couldn't hurt too much, so don't worry about it. Winning money today for the red section. Also first times on our show. Rookies again, Mr. Harvey Miller and his gal, Diana Ewing. Harvey, you can applaud yourself. Don't listen to Richard. He'll make your life miserable if
he's
you can.
He's trying to get me upset and it won't work.
That's it. See, it's competition. That's his tactics. Don't let him bother you. Diana, are you ready to go, dear?
Yes.
Okay. If you're all ready, here is the first question worth $150. It's for the ladies. Ladies, the market is flooded with how-to books about sex. But honestly, since you've been an adult, have you ever learned anything about sex from a how-to book? Okay, I'll say it again. The market is flooded with how-to books about sex. But honestly, since you've been an adult, have you ever learned anything about sex from a book, from a how-to book? Think it over, girls. We'll come back and find out in a moment. I can hardly wait to hear the answer. Richard, what will Jody say to that? Has she ever
Only thing I think she's ever learned. You're right, that is catching.
That's Bo. No, Bo talks that way.
Only thing she's learned about those how-to books is not to buy them.
Really?
Yeah, I think she's written two or three in secret.
Really?
I think she'll say she's never learned anything from those.
Yeah, are you sure?
Yeah.
You're sure?
We've done a lot of research.
I understand. Let's bring Jody on quickly. Here she comes now. Hello, Jody. Jody, since you've been an adult, have you ever learned anything about sex from a how-to book?
It's very difficult. But I believe experience is the best teacher.
The answer is no.
No.
That's right. That's the correct answer. Absolutely right. I don't think I'll press that any further. Thank you, Jody. Bo, what's Sondra going to say to this?
Well, I've never found any books around the house, so I don't think she's read any books. I do.
You do? Oh, really? Want to give us a couple of titles?
Well,
No, it's all right. You're going to say she'll say no, huh? All right, let's bring her on and find out. Sondra, have you ever, since you've been an adult, learned anything about sex from a how-to book?
No.
That's right. That's what Bo said. See, wasn't that easy? Yeah, see, now you can relax. And the banana section says, oh, she's going to be fine. Harvey, what's Diana going to say?
No.
She's going to say, oh.
Absolutely
Could
not.
You be a little more brief with your answer?
I can only speak from my own experience. I've never seen her read a book while we were in bed. I don't know what she does with it. I would say no.
You'll take a wild guess and say no.
I'd say absolutely no.
All right, let's bring her on and find out. Diana, have you ever, since you've been an adult, learned anything about sex from a how-to book?
No.
That's it. You're right. Everybody's right. That's short and sweet. We'll come back in a moment and give away a lot more money for each question on TattleTales. See you in a moment. After this break. Question number two coming up. This is it. If you are ready, ladies, the question's for you. It's worth $150. Ladies, a strange and eerie woman at a party claims you insulted her. She tells you she's a witch and she's going to cast a spell on you and you're going to have an accident. Now, the next day, you have a minor automobile accident. Would you attribute this to the spell or simply to coincidence? Ooh, a strange and eerie woman at a party claims you have insulted her, and she tells you you're gonna have an accident because she's a witch and she's cast a spell on you. The next day, you have indeed a minor automobile accident. Are you gonna attribute this to her spell or to simply a coincidence? That's an interesting question. Think about it. We'll come back in a moment. Off they go. Bo, we'll start with you. How does Sondra feel about witches and all of that stuff?
She's never told me anything about him, but, I'd say she'd just say that it was a coincidence.
You think so?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's bring Sondra on and see what she says. An eerie woman says, "You will have an accident. You've insulted me." Now, you do have one. Would you attribute that to her spell or that it's just a coincidence?
Sondra. Is that me?
Yeah, I didn't say your name, Donovan.
Definitely attributed to her.
That's not what Bo said.
No! I'm the most superstitious person in the whole world.
Ah, see, Bo didn't know that.
I throw salt over my shoulder and won't walk under ladders.
Uh-huh. See, Bo, you live and you learn, right?
Well, I got my string, see? I thought I was the only one who was superstitious.
What is your string? What is that?
Well, when I was doing a picture with Burt Reynolds, he told me if I wore the string that I could do another picture with him. So I did another picture with him after that, and then I decided to go out on my own. You know, I already made his career. He's on his own now.
Yeah, but you're still wearing the string, right?
Yeah, I'm superstitious. I'm the one that's superstitious.
You didn't know she was.
Well, she never told me.
Now you know. If it ever comes up again today, you'll know.
I don't know.
Harvey, what about Diana? What would she do?
Diana will attribute to coincidence.
She will?
Unless she happens to back into the witch.
Whoops.
Boom. But I would say, no, she doesn't. She's not very superstitious, and I'd say she would definitely say it would be a coincidence.
She would, huh?
Oh, sure.
Oh, sure, he says. Okay. No problem. Let's bring on Diana, please, if you don't mind. Diana, the witch says she's cast a spell, you'll have an accident, and you do. Are you going to say that that's her spell or an accident, or coincidence?
Coincidence.
That's it. Not superstitious, eh, Diana?
Not a bit.
Not
That's
at
it,
all.
Baby, tell him.
All right.
Knock on wood.
Yes, right. Richard, what will Jody say to this?
Well, Jody's weird. She played a couple of tapes that she made of a visit in Chicago to a fortune-telling lady. And the only thing I think that came out of it was she was out $40.
Right.
Well, she's I think she's very willing to believe, but I've tried to explain to her that I think all that is hocus pocus. So I think and hope she'll say it's a coincidence.
With
if
his fingers
not,
crossed.
I'll put a spell on her.
Have you got your rabbit's foot handy too? He's got his fingers crossed. Let's bring Jody
on. Hold your string.
Here she comes now. Jody.
Man.
Now, the witch says, you will have an accident. You've insulted me. And by golly, the next day, you have an automobile accident. Would you attribute that to her spell or to just coincidence?
I truly would attribute it to coincidence.
That's right. And I hope it never happens to you. Jody and Richard, Diana and Harvey split the pot at halftime, so let's step to the way out. We'll bring the ladies out front. We'll come back with the second half of TattleTales momentarily. See you tomorrow. We'll be right back. I was just talking to some people here who come, and what they do, they come in groups and then turn their winnings over to their special cause, which, or their charity, which is really a lovely idea. I think it's a nice idea to do. I hope you all win some money for your particular cause. And fellas, here you go. This question is worth $150. It's for you. Men, you're one of the judges of a beauty contest. You're about to cast your vote for a beautiful contestant with a really spectacular figure. At that moment, you learn that her lovely bust line was the result of silicone injections. Would you still cast your vote for her? I'll say it again. You're one of the judges of a beauty contest. You're about to cast your vote for a beautiful contestant with a really spectacular figure. At that moment, you learn that her lovely bust line was the result of silicone injections. Would you still cast your vote for her? Off they go. Think about it, fellas, and enjoy yourselves. We'll be back in a moment. We'll start with you, Diana. What would Harvey do?
Harvey would change his vote and not vote for the girl who had the silicone injections.
He would, huh?
Yes, because he prefers things natural. I mean, not totally natural, of course, but I mean, that might get in the way of other things, you know, if there was silicone.
Uh-huh. Just keep talking. I'm not going to have any idea of this.
I ain't going to say no more.
Okay. You'll say he would not vote for her. He would. Would you still cast your vote? The answer is no. Let's bring Harvey on, that purist. Harvey.
Yes.
Now you find out that this beauty has silicone injections. Her bust line ain't all hers, right? What are you going to do? You going to still cast your vote for her or no?
I think I will, yes.
Wrong. I guess Harvey had a clearer picture in his mind of what we were talking about than Diana did.
Did I say something wrong?
Yes, you did, sir. Oh. Diana said that you would not cast your vote. Would you like to explain that to him, Diana?
Well, Harvey.
Well, Diana, I mean, I've had silicone,
you know. Do I have
to
explain this to you?
Yes. Well, I just don't think that that's all that counts in a beauty contest, you know?
Uh-huh.
What are you talking about?
But why would you vote for her, then?
Yeah, what would you vote for her for?
Well, don't yell, because I've had...
I am whispering. I'm not yelling.
I've had silicone myself, and nobody holds it against me, so...
I forgot. I'm sorry.
Moving right along, folks. Let's come right down the line to Jody here. Jody, what do you think, Richard? I'm dying to know where he had it, yeah. Jody, it wasn't up your nose, was it, Harvey? No. What about Richard? What's he going to say to this?
I think he would change his vote.
Would, huh?
Also.
He'd be outraged, wouldn't he?
Yes, he would. I think silicone, he has said that silicone turns him off.
Right. So. I never saw a piece of silicone I was crazy about either. Not to mention it.
Does turn him off. So I believe he would change his vote.
He will say, no, he would not cast his vote for our silicone
That's
beauty.
Correct.
Let's bring Richard on. Richard, now you are the judge, sir. You've really picked out this girl. She's a knockout. However, at the last moment, just as you're about to vote for her, you find out she has indeed had silicone injections. Would you still cast your vote for her?
The thing that intrigues me is how did I find that out?
Well, they probably have an official silicone tester that does that. Maybe you could get that job if you're lucky, huh?
I hope they don't have one. You see, I believe if the good Lord had wished us to have those things, he would have given us all silly putty. I would withdraw my vote and leave her flat.
That's it. Okay. You're absolutely right, Richard. Thank you.
Well, thank you.
I said it first.
Well, you did, of course.
That's true. Let's move right along to Sondra. What's Bo going to say? What will he do?
Well, I'm torn. Now, I think that Bo definitely likes the voluptuous type. I mean, can't you tell by looking at me? But I think he would be very turned off at discovering that.
He will.
So I think he would change his vote.
He would. He would not cast his vote for her.
I think he definitely would not.
All right, let's bring Bo on and see what he says. Here he comes. Bo, you're the judge, the beauty contest. You pick out a beauty. But then at the last moment, just as you're about to vote for her, you find out she's had silicone injections in her bust line. Easy for you to say. Would you still cast your vote for her, or would you not?
Yeah, I'd still vote for him.
That's not what Sondra said. Living and learning our way through the banana section, it's called. Sorry about that, Bo.
Wouldn't make any... Bo!
Well, I'd deal every little bit counts.
Yes, and with that, we say that Jody and Richard have got the entire pot for the blue section. With our $300 question, which will decide today's show. Come back. Here we go. Okay, here we go. This is the $300 question. This will decide the show for today, and here it is. If you're ready, fellas, which of the two of you gets more impatient when you're trying to explain something to the other? Ooh, good question. You or your lady. Which of the two of you gets more impatient when you're trying to explain something to your lady? You or your lady? Which one? Think it over. Off they go. I mean, haven't you felt that a million times? If I'm trying to explain it to you, we'll listen one more time. Here we go. I'm having a wonderful time here. Sondra...
Oh, no.
Between you and Bo, who gets more impatient?
You're making me so nervous. Well, I'm a very calm and placid, easygoing person. I can say something 20 times and I wouldn't mind. Bo, definitely. He gets very tense if you don't understand exactly what he's talking about.
Right. He then, obviously, is the one who gets more impatient while trying to explain.
I hope he knows that.
Okay.
Well, he may not know it.
He may not know it, but he is. Let's bring him on. Bo, which of the two of you does get more impatient when you're trying to explain something to the other?
I do.
That's it. Victory! The banana section want appropriately bananas on that one, and they should, too. Diana, how about Harvey? What's he going to say?
Well, if Harvey tells the truth,
yes,
he will say that he gets more impatient than I do. However, we do have times when we become like two lawyers in a courtroom, you know, and we're just, I told you this, you know,
okay.
And on and on.
But it's Harvey?
I would say it's Harvey, you know,
yes.
Well, he's a short little guy and he gets real feisty,
yeah.
You know, always had to fight his way around places, you know.
Right, okay, let's bring Harvey on here. Harvey,
yes,
you and Diana are having a discussion. Which of you gets more impatient when trying to explain something to the other?
I do.
That's it. You got it.
Thank you. Okay, yes, I'm guilty. Thank you. You see, that's where the silicone came in. It was injected into my brain.
Oh, there's where it is. I knew it went someplace. Right. I have to tell you in our audience, too, because The Odd Couple, which you produced and wrote and did everything, was my very favorite show on television.
Thank you. It was mine, too.
Oh, I think it's one of the greats of all time. I really miss it. Okay, Jody, what's Richard going to say?
This is simple.
We've heard that before, haven't we, Blue Section?
Because he definitely is the more impatient of the two of us. He says such lovely things to me as, during an argument, you know, you have the brains of a pig.
The brains of a pig?
Yes.
Hey, I think pigs rank pretty high in the animal kingdom. They
That's
really do.
Pigs are very smart. Intelligent. So
see, he shows what he knows.
Putting down the pigs.
Okay, so you'll say it's him. Let's bring him on. Here comes Richard now.
Yeah.
Richard, you and Jody are having, shall we
what
say, a discussion.
What took so long getting to... I'm sorry.
Oh, see, you were impatient there, Richard. Between you and Jody, which one would you say was a little more impatient trying to explain something to the other?
I mean, this is the simplest thing in the world.
Oh.
And I'm sick that I have to tell you this, Bert.
Oh, you've tried to tell me before.
To me.
That's right. Thank you for explaining that to me, Richard.
Let me
explain. All right, we split it three ways, gang. The $300 goes on the board. However, time is up. The blue section with Jody and Richard wins it. We will be back in just a moment to let you know how much the blue section has won. Please come back. See you after this session. The blue section with Jody and Richard won it today, $375. We had $1,000, a total of $1,375. That's very nice. See? Sir, how are things going on match game?
Everything's fine on the match game.
Match game is now evening too, right?
Evening as well on ABC.
Isn't that terrific?
And it's marvelous.
Yeah.
It's a good show.
It is a good show.
Keeps us off the streets.
Yeah, that's true. And Jody, how's everything with you? Singing your heart out.
Right. Working clubs all over the world.
I'm glad to hear it. Please, see you next time on TattleTales. Bye, everybody.
This is Gene Woods speaking for TattleTales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.